So, the 2021-22 Los Angeles Lakers have played 48 minutes of NBA regular season basketball, and those 48 minutes came in a 121 to 114 loss to the Warriors. And I think there's definitely some interesting things about it. So, in this video, I'm just going to be talking about how the Lakers played last night. Starting with LeBron, because I thought he looked really good. 34 points, 11 rebounds, 5 for 11 from 3, 13 for 23 from the floor, started 6 for 6, and I thought he looked healthy. I thought on his jump shots he had good elevation, and it's clear that he had an offseason to rest where he didn't have a deep playoff run, and yeah, I think he looked really good. I think defensively too, he was decently engaged, had a block on Jordan Poole, and he just looked good on both ends of the floor. The jump shot looked good, got a few rebounds. I think he took a charge. So overall, I thought, yeah, LeBron looked pretty good. And Anthony Davis, I also thought looked pretty good. He also had 33 points and 11 rebounds. A lot of the times he was matched up against Bielitsa or Juan Toscano-Anderson, and they were feeding him in the post. And I think the spacing on those post-ups wasn't great from the Lakers, but I think Anthony Davis still managed to make it work. He had a few fadeaways, he had a few jump hooks, and then sometimes he just had to kick it out. So he also looked healthy too, had a few blocks, that sort of thing. So LeBron and Anthony Davis, I thought both played well and both looked good and healthy, which is a good sign for the Lakers. And after that, I thought it was a bit less good. So they started with DeAndre Jordan and Kent Bazemore as the starters. It's clear Bazemore was in there to guard Curry, and Jordan was in there as the center, instead of Dwight Howard. But they did play Anthony Davis at center a fair amount, and those were my favorite minutes because it gave them more spacing. And yeah, I just thought they looked a lot better. It looked a lot less congested in those minutes. Now let's talk about Westbrook because he didn't have a good game. 8 points, 5 rebounds, 4 assists, 4 for 13 from the field, 0 for 4 from 3. And I don't think he was. I think the looks he was getting weren't terrible, but he obviously didn't play very well. A few times he just came up and shot a three or a mid-ranger, and those just weren't very good looks. I thought they maybe could have gotten him a bit more involved off the ball, because when he was off the ball, he was just standing around and not really being guarded. He cut one time and it was good. I think maybe some screen setting from him, maybe using him in handoff actions could be a bit more exciting, but there I didn't really see too much of that against the Warriors. So, maybe that changes and they make a few adjustments. It is the first game of the season, so they do have plenty of time. The Lakers were also missing a few players: Trevor Ariza, Talen Horton-Tucker, Kendrick Nunn. And that meant that Rajon Rondo played 20 minutes, and I didn't think he was bad, but I thought the minutes where Rondo and Westbrook were out there at the same time were not good, and clearly those only happened because of the injuries to the Lakers, because having Rondo and Westbrook out there at the same time just makes no sense. Rondo and Westbrook, they both need the ball, and they're both non-shooters off the ball, so just stagger them and have one of the two, because together it's just very redundant and neither one of them makes a positive impact off the ball. After that, DeAndre Jordan, Dwight Howard, not much to talk about. How many minutes did they get combined? 26 minutes. So yeah, Anthony Davis at center, that happened for a decent amount of the game, which it's pretty exciting. Malik Monk, I thought he was okay when he came off the bench. It's clear to see that he can get picked on defensively, but he also has some shot making offensively. And Avery Bradley also came in and hit two threes. Oh yeah, Melo. Melo, I thought he was okay. I thought the 3-point shooting is obviously needed, and being him being able to space the floor, you clearly see he's someone you need to guard out there, and you can't just ignore, because a lot of the times the Warriors were just ignoring Westbrook and Rondo. But with Carmelo, you have to stay attached to him. Yet I was a bit unhappy with some of the mid-rangers that he was taking, some of the times where they threw it to him in the post, when I just don't think that's the best option. I think, you know, I'd rather have LeBron and AD involved. I'd rather have Westbrook running a pick and roll if it's with the bench unit. So we'll see how fast they cut those out, or if that's just going to be a little part of their offense, throwing it to Melo for a mid-ranger. So yeah, overall for the Lakers, I think definitely some positives with LeBron and Anthony Davis looking good. But like everyone said, this is going to be a work in progress. They are going to need to find ways to get Westbrook more involved. And Westbrook is just going to have to play a little better. I think he will. There's plenty of time. It's clear they have a lot of good basketball players. And they do have some injuries. But still something that they need to figure out. But anyways, thanks for watching, leave a like, subscribe to this channel for more NBA content, and I'll see you guys next time.